Bob, what is the usefulness of Hemi-Sync in exploring different states of consciousness?
In exploring different states of consciousness, Hemi-Sync, first of all, is tremendously valuable for one reason, and that is that it's not like a drug, it's not like a chemical, it is a sound, and as a sound, it in turn doesn't invade the body, as it were. It's not even like electrical stimulation where you force the body to do things by electricity. What it also means is that the mind can accept it or reject it. In other words, it's not something that forces itself into you like this. It says here, and it is. So the applications are so broad that we really don't know all of them. We uncover new ones all the time. Let's take the extremes. You can use Hemi-Sync to keep you awake, totally focused attention, wide awake and alert. And over here, you can put a person to sleep, into natural sleep. And the in between are all of these many, many different ways, different states of consciousness that Hemi-Sync can be used to perform things. And let's go to the wake stage first of all. You can be super awake. And what do we mean by say super awake? Intense focus of attention, concentration, so that you all of your attention is focused on, say, a book or something like this. And by that focusing, you achieve much greater retention and much greater understanding just as you do focus your attention. But this helps you do it to a degree perhaps that you've never been able to do before, that type of focusing of attention. Bang, like that. Now you can change that just a little bit by, in turn, again, using Hemi-Sync, and then move into a physical pattern of stimulating physical activity. And that's why, again, focusing of attention on physical activity in sports, for example. And we have an application that we used in golf that the best example we know, the president of this state golf association sliced 11 strokes off his score just by using this. It's that kind of thing. But it is because it let him focus his attention on the physical activity. Then you move, and you can see something's taking place here, that you can then move that focus of attention in many different ways. It's great because you can take that whole skein of wakefulness and use it in a number of different ways. Then the next thing that importantly takes place is that you can shift that attention, that mind consciousness, into other types of states, all the way down, and you're not even asleep yet. Look at this. And there's all of these in between. And we have some very profound ones that we've developed that, mind you, you're not asleep, but you are awake. So we have a state that we can achieve by Hemi-Sync that lets your mind be awake and your body asleep. Now that means that the characteristics of your body, your physical body, are asleep. And this makes a very, very great discovery available to you, and that is that you don't need all that physical sensory input of your five senses to be awake, to be able to think, to be conscious. And that's a great, great discovery, because we always think we have to have all this physical sensory input in order to think. We don't need it. And that's a big discovery. And Hemi-Sync lets you get there very easily to learn that important pattern. So that's an illustration. In between these things are various states of consciousness that say that let the psychiatrist or the analyst reach in and get into the various depths of that other part of that patient to find out what his problems are and let them surface, because He establishes different means of getting into them like that, but they're not the same as that strictly mind awake, body asleep. This hemisync pattern will let you do that. So you can see the scope of, I'm speaking, it's anything that the mind can do, hemisync lets it, lets you help you do that by changing the focus of attention, the focus of consciousness. So you see, one of the things that begins to emerge here is through the use of these sound patterns, we can help, not force, the mind to get into these other ways of thinking, if you put it that way, these other ways of perceiving. And as I'm prone to say, that the whole concept that I found in out-of-body is past this wall we call sleep. Because we think of sleep as unconsciousness, and we have all these other forms of being unconscious, and sleep is the most common of those unconscious states. So what we're doing, utilizing this hemisync, is to let the individual have, for the first time, control over his consciousness. And in relation to that, one of the key things that we have found is that this can, once we help a person learn this particular state, he in turn is as if he can restore that at will. He can, he has a memory of it, and he can recall it. It's as if you can recall when you were, let's say, dancing in the dark, if you want, or whatever, that you can recall it, and there it is again. So if you can have a given state created by hemisync, you remember the effect, and you can be that again. Very important. So if you take that perspective, you can see that there is no limit, and steadily all the time there are various uses found for this different pattern, and there are multiple patterns. We're so far beyond just one little signal doing something. In our latest approach to it, we each, what we had as one signal, is now seven signals. And we may have as many as five of those one signals that were seven, so we now have something like 35 different hemisync signal patterns on one application or one use. So we've gotten very deep into it. But the whole point that's so significant to us is what has emerged out of all of this. What has come out is that, first of all, because bear in mind that we have long ago gone past, quite naturally, because I demanded it, I needed the answers. So we went past this thing, this unconsciousness called sleep, to find out what was happening later on, where we are not getting too much signals from the physical body. What's happening out there? And there was an important thing came out of it, and that is that consciousness is a continuum. It does not stop when we lose consciousness here. If we are not conscious here, we are conscious there, whatever there is. I don't pretend to say what that definition of there is, but we are there. So that means very simply, when you go to sleep here, you don't lose consciousness, you just shift along the spectrum of consciousness to another kind of wakefulness. And we in turn, with this consciousness, attempt to understand that phasing, that part of human consciousness at work there, and it's very difficult. So we try it and use dreams and all sorts of things to try and attempt to understand that consciousness, that being there, again, whatever there is. And out of that, saying that we don't know how far that spectrum of consciousness goes, that long band, it's endless. And we call that the interstate.